it's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, StraightSmileSolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about measuring transverse width in mixed dentition kids to find out if they need expansion or not. So I have tons of videos on everything expansion. If you want to watch those videos, you can just go to StraightSmileSolutions.com, click on education, and you will see our videos, have access to our phase one playlist. Another great resource is our My Phase One Smile Index, which is copyrighted and I created it to help you screen mixed dentition kids to find out if they need ortho. But specifically, if you wanna know if somebody needs an expander or has a constricted maxilla, I'll kinda take you through my thoughts on that and how to know and how to use a Bowley gauge to measure transverse width. Now, this is loosely based on what McNamara teaches. So McNamara teaches that, and he's a super pro expansion orthodontist, he teaches that you would use the cemento enamel junction of the sixes, which is 3 and 14. But to me, finding the CEJ sometimes on kids with gum and puffy gums is tricky. So I've kind of modified it, and I know a lot of other people do that too, where I use the mesial palatal cusp tips. And of course, you guys, this is just like super rough, like different morphologies and different anatomies and different tooth sizes and shapes and rotations. This is, like I said, it's just a screening tool that you mesh with all your other screening tools, like in My Phase One Smile, to find out if you need phase one orthodontics or, you know, arch expansion as part of your phase one treatment. So when I use a Bowley gauge, and I like Bowley gauges because they can be autoclaved, but if you don't have a Bowley gauge in your office, you can always take a little piece of floss and just stretch it across from cusp tip to cusp tip, trim it, and then lay it against, well, you can even capture that with an iPhone measuring device. Also, if you have a scanner, like you can just calibrate it off. You can just take the number off the scanner. So this is like super old school, but basically you're going to go, like I said, mesial palatal cusp tip to mesial palatal cusp tip, this to this. This is actually my daughter and her measurement. And this is after she had expansion. So you can see how nice and broad her arch is. And oh my goodness, why can I not see this number? I think I have to almost look at it. It's up 40 something. Yeah, I think it's about 43. So the magical number to me is 40 millimeters if you're going mesial palatal cusp tip to mesial palatal cusp tip. So this is after expansion. So like I said, that is for average size teeth, which she has. So nice broad arch form. This is actually my son. A little older than this one was this one. He did not have expansion, but he did have some basic phase one orthodontics. We did not use an expander, although he probably got some arch expansion in that. But you can see that to that, and he's right on 40. So that's why I didn't use an expander. So you can see the difference, right? So other things that we're gonna look for. We're also gonna look at the anatomy of the palate. So I don't wanna see anything like vaulted or anything like that. You know, V-shaped, the shape of the arch. There's a lot of things we're looking for. We also wanna look at just general space. Do we have space to line up all the teeth? So, you know, in this situation, maybe like a millimeter space deficient, we're good here, millimeter deficient here, a millimeter deficient here, but there's some space that you get here and here when the E's are lost, so I would call this just about even, and he ended up never actually needing real orthodontics, just a little bit of EG, eruptive guidance appliances, and I think he needed like 4 aligners, so that's why that all worked out, the puzzle piece worked out. This one, we've already done the expansion, so now, yep, once you close up these spaces, you got plenty of space. So again, you've got extra space from the E space. So this one has plenty of space. So just things to look at. Again, this is just a rough guesstimate, things to help you make that decision if you're on the fence about expander or no expander. To me, always better to have more space than less space. I can always close it up later. Much more difficult to make space, and having a nice broad smile is considered extremely aesthetic. It's also healthier for the airway and for the tongue position. So if you're on the fence, I say better to go for it. Remember, you can get some arch expansion with wires, with aligners, but it's not palatal or skeletal expansion, so you're not gonna have all the same airway effects you would as if you actually opened up those palatal shelves. So I say why not if you're on the fence. Get your Bully gauge. You can buy these even from eBay just for $6 or $7. They're really useful. I'm sure you had one in dental school, but great instruments. So hopefully this is helpful. All right, thank you.